Hi everyone, welcome to Match Math. Today we are going to study from class 10th, chapter 5, Arithmetic Progressions. Let's see the introduction part for exercise 5.1. We'll try to understand first of all what is arithmetic progression. So you see some set of numbers here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here you see 1, 3, 5, 7, and here you see 6, 12, 18, and 24. Let's see, is there any pattern here? So if you see here, from 1, if we are adding plus 1, if we add to this 1, if we add plus 1, it gives us 2. Then again to this 2, if we add plus 1, it will give us 3. Again to this 3, if we add plus 1, will give us 4. Again if you add plus 1, you will get 5. So that means you see there is some pattern is being followed, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. So when we add plus 1, we get the next number. When we add plus 1 to this, we get next number. When you add plus 1 here, we get next number. So there is a pattern. So if you see here also, you see here 1, 3, 5, 7. So here 1, 3, 5, 7 also, if with 1, if we add plus 2, if we add plus 2, gives us 3. So same way to this 3, if we add plus 2, we get 5. Again to this 5, if we add plus 2, it gives us 7. So here you see there is a pattern, plus 2, plus 2, plus 2. So same way, let's see here also. To this 6, if we add plus 6, we get 12. So same way, from 12, if you are adding plus 6 to this 12, we are getting 18. Now again, to this 18, if we add plus 6, we get 24. So there is some pattern is being formed. So when adding the same number, if a pattern is formed, that we call it arithmetic progression. So you see, this is the difference it is given, the definition that is given to you. An arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding terms except the first term. That is called arithmetic progression. So in short, we call it AP. Now this fixed number is called common difference of the AP. Remember that it can be positive, negative, or zero. So now let's see, there are some more things to learn from here. So we see there is some fixed number being added to the previous term. Okay, so then that gives us an AP or arithmetic progression. Now something called terms and something called common difference. Now if you see each number, this each number is called terms. So this is first term, second term, third term, fourth term and fifth term. So each number is called terms. So here also you see first term, second term, third term, fourth term. Here also first term, second term, third term, fourth term. So each number is called terms, and these terms we denote like this. A, either you write A or A1 also is okay, or A1 we say, because some place they say A, some place they say it A1. So either of that. Then A2, A3, A4 and so on. So we call it, this is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. So then something called common difference. Common difference means the same number that we are adding. So between these two, what is the difference? One is the difference. Between these two, you see, one is the difference. So this, the pattern that the fixed number is called a common difference, and that we call it as D. So now in this term, here A is what, or A1 is what? A1 is here 1, and A2 is what here in this case? 2. So same way here, D is what here? D is 1. The difference is 1 here. So same way, let's see the second part also. Here the terms, okay, so A1 is what here? A1 is 1. A2 is what here? 3. A3 is what here? That is 5. So these are terms. So we call it A1, A2, A3, A4. Each term we have name. So then common difference here. D is what here? The d is what here? Here we have 2. 2 is the one fixed number here, which is this number is being added for the each term. So d is what here? D is 2. So here you see, here a is what? A or a1 is 6. Then a2 is what? 12. And a3 is what? 18. And then difference. What is the difference here? Difference is 6 here. Each number we are adding 6 to get the next number. So this is called arithmetic progression. I hope you are understanding. Now the common difference can be, it can be positive, it can be negative, or it can be 0. This is D. D can be positive, D can be negative, D can be 0. Now here we are adding. In some cases you need to minus. So provided the common pattern is being followed. Now as we see, you will understand. So let's proceed. Now you see something called, there are two types of AP is there. Finite AP and infinite AP. Finite AP means, like for example, 10, 20, 30 and so up to 100. So this is finite AP because we full stop here. But if the same thing I write down, same thing, then I put it dot dot dot. What is the meaning of this? This means so on. It will go on and on and on. So this is infinite AP and this is finite AP because this is 10 to 100 only. But this is dot 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 means it can go on and on. So this is called infinite AP. Now let's with the example. I'm sure you will understand this arithmetic progression concept. So let's see some example. Check whether it is AP or not. So let's check whether it is AP or not. So we know that this is A1, this is A2, A3, A4, A5. Because these are the terms. Now how we will check? We will check first of all the common difference. Common difference, how we check? Common difference, normally we check the common difference, we call it D. Okay. So D is our common difference. So we will find out the D value. How we find out D value? From the previous number, we have to minus the first number. That is from A2, we will minus A1. A2, we are minusing A1. So A2 is what? A2 is 3. Minus A1 is what? 1. So that will give us what? 2. So same way, let's find out D for the next. That is for A3, we will minus A2. So from A3 we will minus A2. A3 is what? 6. A2 is what? 3. So what will give us? Answer will be 3. So this is our D value we are finding out, right? Means common difference. The difference between the two numbers we are finding out. So let's see the next number. The next number is, we'll see from A4 we will minus A3. So A4 is what? 7. From 7 we will minus 6. So we will get answer 1. So if you see this way, if we do all the numbers, what we are getting? The difference, the D value is here 2, here 3, here 1. So therefore this is not AP. I hope you understood now. AP means the D value should be same. From this number when we minus here, the difference should be same. From here when you minus here, from here when you minus this, the between this pattern should be same. I told you, know this pattern should be same. Then only it will be arithmetic progression. If not, it won't be. So if the D value differs, means common difference between this number is different number, then this is not AP. So now another one type of example, we'll see. Find AP series. So A value is given to us, D value is given to us. So now we have to find the AP series. So how we will find out? We have to get the value for A1, A2, A3. That is what AP series, right? So now we know A is 10. Either you say A or A1, no problem. You can say A1 also, no problem. So A1 is 10. Now let's find out A2. So A2 means the next term. So next term A2 means with A, you will add the common difference. Common difference is given to us. So A is what? A is 10 plus common difference is D is what? 4. So that will give us 40. So same way, we want to find out A3. So for A3, we'll find out, here we finished with A1, right? A1 plus D. So now A2 plus D. So A2 is what? A2 we have got here. This is A2, right? See, this is A2. This is A1. This is A2. So now A3 to get it, we plus A2 plus D. A2 is 14. D is what? D is 4. So we will get 18. So this is our A3. So now we want to find out A4. So for A4 we'll add with A3, we will add the D. So A3 is what? 18. And D is what? 4. So that will give us 22. So now next, A5. So now A5 to get, we have to add with A4 D. So then we will get 22 plus 4 will give us 26. So now this is AP series, that is 14, 18, 22, 26. This is AP because all the common difference is same, because when we add with the 14, when we add 4, we get 18. With 18, when we add 4, we get 22. With 22, when we add 4, will give us 26. So same difference is the same. So this is AP. So now there is one more formula also. Instead of doing like this, you also use like this to get the series. So A is what? A is 10. Okay. Now A plus D. A is 10, right? A is 10. Plus D is what? D is 4. So that will give us 14. Now A is 10. Then 2 into D is 4. So that means 10 plus 4 twos are 8. So 10 plus 8 will give us 18. So here also 10 plus 3 into 4. This will give us 22. So then 10 plus 4 into 4. D is 4. So this will give us 26. So you can follow either this formula to find the AP series, or you can do this way also. A1 plus D, A2 plus D, A3 plus D, A4 plus D. Means along with the previous number, you go on add the difference. I hope I made the things clear to you. This is very interesting chapter. You will enjoy it, provided you understand the concept. That's it. Thank you and God bless you.